Hi guys, welcome. Hi guys, I'm back. Welcome back to my channel. I'm finally come back to India after my USC and I'm back to making videos for you. Today's video is going to be the first video of an important series called USMLE Resources. I found that a lot of people now know what resources to use but not really how to use them well. And I'm going to try and touch upon all the really common resources available for USMLE, and I'm going to tell you what the best way is to use them and harness the potential in them so you can get the best score possible. Today's video, I'm going to start with two giants. Like, everybody knows these resources, and I'm going to tell you exactly when to start using them, how to use them, and how to monitor your progress on them. So let's get started. So the first resource is UWorld, and I don't think there's anybody who's preparing for USMLE who hasn't heard of UWorld. So UWorld, despite being only a Q bank, it's surprisingly one of the best learning resources also. That being said, I wouldn't recommend starting off with UWorld to build your knowledge. So it's really important to know when you need to start using UWorld. My personal preference and my suggestion for you guys is to start using UWorld once you've built a foundation of knowledge. For example, in step one, once you've read first aid once, or done your Boards and Beyond videos, I would suggest starting UWorld. Whereas for step two, because your foundation knowledge is already built in, you can start UWorld a little earlier. So for step one, let's say maybe 2 months into prep, you start UWorld. Whereas for step two, you start UWorld immediately because your foundation's already built. Next. How do you do UWorld? So there's always this age-old debate on timed versus tutor. In my preference, you always do tutor mode because it saves you on time. Because when you do tutor mode, you read the question and the explanation at the same time. So I would suggest using tutor mode for at least the first 4/5 of your prep and only start doing timed mode in the last 1/5 of your prep. So if your prep time is 5 months, 4 months of tutor mode and 1 month of timed mode. I'll tell you exactly why this is, because when you're doing it in tutor mode, you know how your brain is working. You know that, okay, this is a question, this is what I thought, and if it's wrong, your brain can correct it right then and there. Whereas when you do it in time mode, you're doing like 40 questions and you kind of lose what your thought process was when you're coming back to review it. So if you're trying to build knowledge and you're starting out USMLE for the first time, I would really suggest doing tutor mode. And then once you've gained enough foundation and confidence, you can switch over to time mode. Then the second debate, it's always, should I do it subject mode or should I do it in random? So if you're USMD, you can do it in random mode because you've already prepared and built knowledge in your first 2 years of medical school. Now, if you haven't done that, and if you're from an IMG, like or an Indian IMG or a non-US IMG, start doing it in subject mode. Because when you do it in subject mode, your brain gets more attuned to a differential diagnosis. Very rarely are you going to have multi-system questions where you won't know which system is involved. You're going to go wrong mostly between very minute differences between differential diagnoses. I'll tell you one which really troubled me. All of the, let's say, myopathies. So there was steroid-induced myopathy, there was statin-induced myopathy, there was hypothyroidism, and there were your dermatomyositis and stuff like that. So all of them have different pathophysiology but very similar presentations. So it was important for me to do all of those similar pathologies and similar myopathies together so I knew how to differentiate them easily. So again, random versus subject, I always say do it in subject mode. So now you're doing UWorld and you want to know where to write all this information down because you're learning so much new information on a daily basis, you need to store it somewhere. one of my best way to do this is download a PDF version of First Aid in your iPad or some kind of a tablet or a phone or on your laptop and start inserting UWord pages in between them. My favorite is GoodNotes, so you can just copy the First Aid PDF into GoodNotes, and whenever you want to add on information, you can just add a page in between, or you can just write over the First Aid. Unfortunately, when I was preparing for step one, I used I'm more of a, like, I need a pen and paper girl. I need to underline, I need to tick marks. So I made my First Aid look like it was a mess. There was just like post-its everywhere, and every corner and column had something important written. But in hindsight, I would always suggest doing a PDF version of it. You can travel with it, you can use it for the rest of your life. It's not cumbersome to do. So start up with the PDF and keep adding your UWord knowledge into your First Aid as extra pages, all in the same page, but it's obviously easy to do digitally. But now there's another tool which I want you to use. So apart from your First Aid, which is very good for step one, in your step two, you really can't, there's no First Aid to fall back on. So you can start using the UWord features called Notebook. So Notebook is essentially a online notebook that you might make notes in. So instead of having to handwrite everything, you can just copy paste parts of UWord that you think are important and organize them in a very, very systematic manner in UWord. So the best part of Notebook is it can be linked. So if you make a notebook for first step one, and when you buy step two subscription of UWord, you will have your step one notebook, so you don't have to rebuild all that knowledge, it's already there. Another feature that I would ask everybody to use, which is a part of UWord, is the flashcards feature. Now, I think a lot of people misunderstand how to use the flashcards. So I didn't really make flashcards in the sense, I didn't really make question and answer flashcards. I just made only the answer flashcards where I could quickly revise important diagrams and tables when I was sleeping or eating or out going to the gym. Something like that was easy to just revise. So don't overload your flashcard with information. If it's a flashcard on Klinefelter syndrome, it should just have the picture of Klinefelter's and maybe one or two important points, and you should be trying to recall everything you know about Klinefelter's when you look at that image. Another interesting thing about flashcards is you can store exterior images in UWord. So if you find an interesting flowchart or an informative diagram online, you can store it in UWord and make a small informative pamphlet about it and just revise it like as you are taking a break or something like that. I would suggest to do like maybe 10 to 15 flash notes when you're in the bed just before you go to sleep. It barely takes 15 minutes, but just the repetitive reinforcement of knowledge will go a long way. Okay, last thing about UWord is UWSAs. These are practice tests that UWord designs that kind of mimic the step one and step two tests. In my experience and scouring Reddit, I have found that the UWSAs aren't as accurate as NBMEs are because the language of the test is different from the language of UWord. So UWord kind of gives you different syntax when describing similar symptoms, whereas NBMEs use a different syntax, and more often than not, UWord questions are more complete. So that's a wrap on UWord, the most important resource that you are going to use in your USMLE prep. I wouldn't advise doing UWord twice. If you're able to do all your marked and incorrect only, you should be good to go and there's no need to do the whole Q bank again. But if you want to be super thorough, I think doing UWord twice for step two is more beneficial than for step one, especially now that's pass or fail. The second resource we're going to be talking about today is AMBOSS. I know you guys have all heard of it, and we all have the confusion of which one to choose. Are you going to go with the AMBOSS QBank or the UWord QBank? Undoubtedly, I think the UWord QBank is superior to AMBOSS, but if you are really short on money, the AMBOSS QBank is a good secondary option. and it is a slightly cheaper than, I think it's significantly cheaper than the UWorld. Now, when to use AMBOSS? AMBOSS can actually be started earlier in your prep before you go into UWorld. You can start using AMBOSS and its library, which is fantastic to learn information and see how you need to apply the information learned before you start your UWorld QBank. Now, I wouldn't suggest doing two QBanks for either of the tests, but if you really want to be thorough, I think the order to go is AMBOSS and then UWorld. If you're not going to take the AMBOSS subscription, they do give you 5 days of AMBOSS for free, which I used in step one and step two. So what I do is in those 5 days, I've already identified all my knowledge deficits. These 5 days are probably the last 2 weeks of prep. And I know I was deficient in immunodeficiency disorders, I was bad at immunology, and I was bad at allergy. So these are the topics that I redid in AMBOSS, and I only did the 4 and the 5 hammer questions. Because the 1, 2 and 3 hammer questions aren't that challenging, you can skip them. So I would suggest once you're at the end of your prep, make a note of all your weak topics and only work on them in those 5 days that AMBOSS gives you for free. Now, if you want to take a longer subscription, please do it, and you can work only on your weak topics with AMBOSS, and you can only do the 4 and the 5 hammer questions for them. One point where AMBOSS is superior to UWorld is the ethics and the biostats questions, because AMBOSS has a larger library, and whenever you do the ethics questions, you can always refer the AMBOSS library, which is a great resource, and you can come back to the question where you're learning and reinforcing the knowledge at the same time. Let's talk about AMBOSS library. Now, that was my favorite resource in step two, because there were so many fragmented resources I used for step two, and none of them had all the information in one place, whereas AMBOSS library did. And actually, even the Lecturio library is pretty good now because it's for free, and the AMBOSS library is paid. But when I was studying, the AMBOSS library was free. And what I would do is I would Google, let's say, cardiomyopathy AMBOSS step 2 CK. And there would be an entire page on cardiomyopathy, which I could just quickly rush through. And if you have an AMBOSS subscription, you can always turn on highlights only, where it only shows you board important questions pertinent to the boards. So summing up AMBOSS, if you're going to buy the whole QBank plus the library, I would suggest doing it before UWorld. But if you're only going to do the QBank for, let's say, 10 days, then please do it at the end of your prep, once you've identified all your weak points. And that's a wrap on AMBOSS. So thank you so much, guys, for coming back to my channel and subscribing. If you like the content and you want to keep supporting it, please like, share and subscribe my video. Please let me know in the comments below what kind of content that you're looking to see from my channel. And look forward for part 2 and part 3, because I will be releasing detailed resources videos about USMLE very soon. And hit the bell icon so you get a notification anytime I upload a new video. Well, take care, stay sane, and keep studying, and bye.